Good morning, brothers and sisters. This is a prophecy report entitled, Ready or Not. In early March 2023, prophecy teacher Amir Sarfati wrote, according to those who gather such statistics, of the 2.4 billion people who bear the label Christian today, only 6.6 believe in the rapture of the church. As one who constantly writes and talks about the rapture, I am well aware there is a widespread unbelief, but it shocks me that only 6.6% of those that call themselves Christians believe in it. This much I do know, every jot and tittle of the word will be fulfilled. And the rapture is going to happen whether church members believe it or not, whether they are ready or not. We cannot know the day and hour, but we can know when it is getting close. And here is information on recent events that seem to indicate that we are getting close. Concerning world government, the cashless society, and tracking all buying and selling, on March 20th, 2023, it was reported that a growing number of U.S. national parks, the Badlands, Crater Lake, and Sleeping Bear, no longer accept cash for entrance fees and other services. These places and more will soon follow, join at least 20 other federal places, Devil's Tower National Monument, FDR's former home, and the Wright Brothers National Memorial, to name a few, that have stopped taking cash. For years, Bible prophecy teachers have taught that tracking all buying and selling requires a cashless society, and it is shaping up now. Concerning a resumption of the animal sacrifices, on March 30th, it was reported that a group of rabbis have petitioned the Prime Minister and the Prime Minister of National Security to allow them to sacrifice an animal on the Temple Mount at Passover. Past governments have not allowed animal sacrifices on the Temple Mount, but Netanyahu's new government is more religious than ever. The Arabs are opposing this, and what happens remains to be seen. Concerning the decline of America, on March 16th, it was reported that Biden's new budget proposal will drastically cut funds to the U.S. Navy. According to the article, Biden wants to prematurely retire 8 ships and 2 combat vessels that have about 600 vertical launch systems that would be needed if we got into a war with China. Concerning the decline of America, on March 29th, it was reported that a high official in the Israeli government said that the Biden administration has recently tried to topple Netanyahu on 2 different occasions. This refutes Biden's claim that he is a friend of Netanyahu and ignores the fact that God promised to bless those that bless Israel and curse those that curse Israel. Why would the U.S. try to topple Netanyahu? The U.S. is siding with liberals, globalists, and Muslim radicals that want Israel to be a secular nation and not a religious nation. They do not want Jews to go by the scriptures, take control of the Temple Mount, rebuild the temple, establish religious settlements on the West Bank, etc. Concerning the decline of America and the coming economic collapse, on April 3rd, the Institute for Supply Management reported that the U.S. factories has reached its lowest point since 2009 in production. According to the article, money that Biden requested for jobs in the U.S. is going to Chinese manufacturers and people that give large sums of money to the Democrat Party. Concerning the decline of America, hyperinflation, and the coming economic collapse, in 2023, Russia announced plans to reduce oil production by 500,000 barrels a day, starting on March 1st and ending on June 30th. On April 2nd, Russia announced plans to extend the 500,000 barrels a day cuts for 6 more months to the end of 2023. On April 2nd, nations announced that they will cut their oil production by 1.15 million barrels a day starting on May 1st and ending at the end of 2023. Now, Russia cutting 500,000 barrels a day and the other nations cutting 1.15 million barrels a day mean there will be 1.65 million fewer barrels a day for the remainder of 2023. The price of gas has already started increasing, and the price of producing food, delivering products to stores, will soon start up again. According to the report, Biden and some Democrats are displeased, but they are the ones that are deliberately hindering oil production in the U.S. And to make matters worse, Biden sold oil from America's strategic oil reserves. He has not replaced it, and our reserves are lower than they have been in about 35 years. Concerning the decline of America, hyperinflation, and the coming economic collapse, on April 3rd, it was reported that America's economic slowdown, consistently high record-breaking inflation, and slowing production are depleting America's Social Security reserves faster than expected. Unless something is done to change course, the system will run out of funds in 2034. Citizens have seen warnings like this before, but it is always an admission that America is experiencing record-breaking inflation. People are losing their jobs, and less money is going into the system. Concerning the decline of America, hyperinflation, and the coming economic collapse, the number of nations that have stopped using dollars for buying or selling oil is growing. Saudi Arabia and Iran will now accept other currencies. Russia and China have agreed to accept each other's currency. China and Brazil have agreed to stop using dollars. And the 10 nations in the Southeast Asia area have announced that they may stop using dollars as well. This is happening because Biden has angered several foreign leaders. They think he is weak, they are turning against him, and they are concerned that his spending is threatening the value of the dollar. Finally, are you rapture ready?